Hey, welcome. In this video, we'll explore the new Enscape Impact module in more detail. We'll show you how it combines data like the shape and dimensions of the building you're designing with its age, type, and location to estimate the environmental impact. If you haven't watched our first video on Enscape Impact, we suggest you do so first. You can find it on the same page you found this video on, or you can find it on YouTube. This will give you an intro to how you use it. Let's dive into the details of Enscape Impact. This new tool provides you with energy performance insights from the early stages of your design. To illustrate this a little better, let's go back to the Settings tab once more. Here, like we did in the last video, we can click the False Color switch to enable a visual representation of the calculations performed in the background, split up room by room. As you can see, Enscape Impact indeed detects the dimensions of each room, and it identifies windows automatically too. You can test various solutions such as different building orientations, geometry features, glazing sizes, and how they impact energy consumption. You get all the indicators you need to help you create sustainable designs for the future. But how exactly does it get to these numbers? Two kinds of data go into the analysis. Data that's derived from your model itself and from the selections you make in the Settings tab. That's the model layout, building age, location, and type. This complete virtual representation of the model is then sent to IES' own Apache engine, which is widely regarded as the best whole building energy simulation engine in the world. This engine will then reference data sets of thermal properties and systems information that are relevant to the chosen building properties. This includes building fabric details, operational schedules, internal space conditions, typical internal loads, heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system types. IES uses datasets from various sources to estimate these values, such as user manuals, weather data, and ASHRAE standards, that's the American Society of Heating, Refrigerating, and Air Conditioning Engineers. In case your building will not be located in the United States of America or Europe, IES will compare it to buildings that match the climate zone of the location you selected. The engine, fully compliant with international standards, then carries out a dynamic thermal simulation using a virtual representation of the building as well as physics-based models of heat transfer processes. The simulation considers the accurate effect of sun time, solar shading, and the solar gain in building spaces. HVAC system definitions provide a complete estimation of energy usage for both the building and its equipment. To summarize, the simulation estimates a number of details about your building based on a gigantic source of real-world data and statistics. This way, you get useful results as fast as possible, already during the initial stages of your design. Let's now review the data Enscape Impact provides us with. Peak load is the highest amount of energy that a building consumes in a set period of time. Total carbon emission calculates released greenhouse gases based on the annual energy consumption of the building. Energy use intensity indicates the energy efficiency of a building's design and operation. It's shown as a building's energy use in relation to its size. Our energy end use estimation is split in the categories cooling, hot water, lighting, equipment, and space heating. Enscape Impact is now available for Windows users with Enscape 4.1 on every design software, offering a free test period for everyone. During this time, we're asking for your feedback. Let us know what you think and what you'd like to see in this new module in future iterations. You can either reach out to us in the forums or leave your feedback in our new ideas portal. You'll find links to both below this video. We hope you'll make great use of this new tool. Thank you for being with us. Until next time.